How an engine starter motor works. What is an engine starter motor and how it works? A starter motor is one of the major components used in an internal combustion engine, which is electrically powered. An engine cannot rotate on its own, a part is required to start the first cycle. The starter motor helps to initiate the engines, which then continually operate on its own power. Before the advent of the starter motor, engines were started by various methods, including wind-up springs, gunpowder cylinders, and human-powered techniques such as a removable crank handle which engaged the front of the crankshaft, pulling on an airplane propeller, or pulling a cord that was wound around an open-face pulley. The hand crank method was commonly used to start engines, but it was inconvenient, difficult, and dangerous. The first electric starter was installed on an Arnold, an adaptation of the Benz Velo, built in 1896 in East Peckham, England, by electrical engineer Herbert John Dowsing. In 1903, Clyde J.Coleman invented and patented the first electric starter motor in America. Later in 1911, Charles Franklin Kettering with Henry Martin Leland of Dayton Engineering Laboratories Company Delco invented and filed for an electric starter in America. Before starting with the working of an electric starter motor, have a look on parts of the starter motor. Below are starter motor's parts: armature, commutator, brushes, solenoid, plunger, lever fork, pinion, and field coils. When the ignition key or button is pressed, the transmission should be in park or neutral state. Being an electrical component, a starter consists of a powerful DC direct current. The solenoid receives positive power direct from the battery and hearth current from the engine body. The battery voltage goes through the starter control circuit to activate the solenoid coil. The solenoid is an electromagnet which requires small current to energize. The solenoid features two coils of wire that are wrapped around the core. One is the pull-in coil, and the other is hold-in coil. The hold-in coil is connected to the casing of the starter motor, so the current returns to the battery by the frame of the car. The frame is connected to the casing of the motor, while the pull-in coil is connected to the main output terminal. This solenoid serves as a switch that connects and closes the electrical connection between the starter motor and the vehicle's battery. As the ignition switch is turned on, the solenoid coils gets energized. A moving core known as a plunger slides along the coil, which connects two copper terminals of a contactor switch. This completes the circuit from the battery to the motor and causes the rotor to spin. When the solenoid is de-energized, the core returns back and disconnects the motor from the battery. We may wonder why the solenoid and the contactor are instead of directly connecting the battery to the motor and reducing the complexity. The reason behind not using this circuit is the high current demand of the motor. The motor is considerably powerful and demands heavy current for operation. To handle this current, the ignition switch needs to be unusually large. It also requires very thick wires running from the battery to the switch and then to the motor, which is technically inconvenient. This is why solenoid is used. The solenoid has also another crucial function. It helps to slide the pinion with the help of lever and engage it with a flywheel before the motor starts to spin. As the pinion slides towards the flywheel, it slightly rotates on its axis. A large current will now flow through the contactors, from there into the brushes. From here it flows to the commutator and through the coils. The coil produces electromagnetic field. Due to this, the rotor or armature rotates. There is an initial period in which the motor turns slowly to allow engagement, so the whole operation is more gentle and causes less wear on the teeth. To make an engine start, it must be turned at some speed, so that it sucks fuel and air into the cylinders and compresses it. The flywheel is mounted on the engine crankshaft. So as the starter motor spins, it turns the flywheel so as the crankshaft. As soon as the engine starts, the system disengages from the flywheel. As we can observe that the pinion is considerably small compared to the flywheel. A planetary gear set is introduced to increase the torque further. Planetary gears are incredibly useful for large gear reductions with less weight and limited space. It consists of a sun gear, a ring gear, a carrier, and a set of planet gears. The combined gear reduction results in enough torque to spin the engine. As the engine started, the pinion disengages. If the pinion does not disengages, the flywheel will rotate the pinion too fast that it will damage the motor. The starter motor has only function is to start the engine. Most drivers improvise if the starter is faulty or battery power is low. The improvising is done by pushing the vehicle forward or backward just to begin the combustion process. The method involves having one or more people push the car so that it gains momentum and the engine can subsequently be started. In an automatic transmission, starter motors can only be operated when the vehicle is in park or neutral position. Automatic transmissions cannot be started using this method. Thanks for watching the video. For more videos, subscribe to my channel.